Fundamentals of rapid prototyping. All types of rapid prototyping techniques adopt same basic approach. They are as follows. First, a component is modeled on a CAD/CAM system. The computer model, which represents the physical component to be built, must be a closed surface, which unambiguously define an enclosed volume. This means that the data must specify the inside, outside, and boundary of the model. It is not required if the modeling technique used is solid modeling. This is because the valid solid model will automatically be an enclosed volume. This requirement ensures that all horizontal cross-sections that are essential to rapid prototyping are closed curves to create the solid object. Now the digital model is converted into a format known as STL, stereolithography, file format. The STL file format approximates the surfaces of the model by polygons. Highly curved surfaces must employ many polygons, which means that STL files for curved parts can be very large. However, there are some rapid prototyping systems which also accept IGES file format. Initial graphics exchange specifications. A computer program analyzes a STL file and slices the model into cross-sections. The cross-sections are systematically recreated in the 3D printer, in the form of a 3D physical model. Other similar methods may also be employed to build the model. Fundamentally, the development of RP can be seen in four primary areas. The rapid prototyping wheel here depicts these four key aspects of rapid prototyping. They are input, method, material, and applications. Input. Input refers to the electronic information required to describe the physical object with 3D data. There are two possible starting points: a computer model or a physical model. The computer model created by a CAD system can be either a surface model or a solid model. On the other hand, 3D data from the physical model is not at all straightforward. It requires data acquisition through a method known as reverse engineering. In reverse engineering, a wide range of equipment can be used, such as coordinate measuring machine or a laser digitizer, to capture data points of the physical model and reconstruct it in a CAD system. Method. While there are currently more than 20 vendors for rapid prototyping systems, the method employed by each vendor can be generally classified into the following categories: photocuring, cutting and joining, melding and fusing, and joining or binding. Photocuring can be further divided into categories of single laser beam, double laser beams, and masked lamp. Material. The initial state of material can come in either solid, liquid, or powder state. In solid state, it can come in various forms such as pellets, wire, and laminates. The current range materials include paper, nylon, wax, resins, metals, and ceramics. Applications. Most of the RP parts are finished or touched up before they are used for their intended applications. Applications can be grouped into 1. Design, 2. Engineering, analysis, and planning, and 3. Tooling and manufacturing. A wide range of industries can benefit from rapid prototyping. Some of them are aerospace, automotive, biomedical, consumer, electrical and electronic products, etc. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more engineering concepts and happy learning.